Welcome to antenna and wave propagation playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain polarization. So let us begin this session with basic definition of polarization. So what is polarization? So polarization is orientation of electric field. So polarization is orientation of electric field. So based on orientation of electric field, one can understand what is the polarization of signal. So before I explain how to understand what is polarization of electromagnetic wave, I'll explain first of all how electromagnetic wave propagates. So here I'll be showing only electric field to understand polarization. So here if I say I have electromagnetic wave which is propagating along with z direction and its orientation is associated with respect to x axis. So if electromagnetic wave that is propagating like this and its maximum amplitude with respect to x, that is E1, then this electromagnetic wave that is having polarization with respect to x-axis. And to explain this, we can write this electric field by Ex, and that is maximum amplitude is E1 into sine omega t minus kx. So that is how, sorry, here it is propagating along with z direction. So it should be sine omega t minus kz. So electric field along with x axis, that is Ex, is equals to electric field is associated with x axis. That's why electric field is with respect to Ex only. And that will be E1, which is what, maximum amplitude with respect to x axis. And omega t, omega is frequency of this electromagnetic wave, and kx, kz, where z is direction of propagation. So that is how one can write this formula of electric field if electric field is propagating along with z direction like this. Now there could be a second way by which one can understand electric field. Like for example, if electric field is propagating along with z direction and orientation is there with y axis, as I am showing it right now, like electric field is varying like this along with y axis, and if I say maximum amplitude is E2, then electric field of this, that could be explained by Ey. The reason is electric field is there with respect to y axis, and that is maximum amplitude is E2. So E2 sine omega t minus kz. So here one thing is very clear. I have shown two electric field waves. One electric field that is there with respect to x axis, and direction of propagation is there in z direction, and second electric field by red line, one can see that is varying with respect to y axis and direction of propagation is in z direction. So that is how electric field that I have shown over here. Now to understand what is linear polarization. So as I have explained, polarization is orientation of electric field. So in linear polarization, orientation of electric field is there with only one axis. So either electric field will vary with respect to x axis or it will vary with respect to y axis. So here I'll show it like, see, this is what x axis and this is y axis, and as by blue color I have shown electric field is varying with respect to x-axis. So for this blue color line, polarization that is there with this direction. If I say this is origin and direction of propagation that is there associated with z direction. So that is there inside the page. Now either it could be plus E1, here it could be plus E1, here it could be minus E1. So it is associated with only x axis. So this is what linear polarization with respect to x axis. So this is linear polarization with respect to x axis. So what is linear polarization? Linear polarization is orientation of electric field is there along with x axis or y axis. It should be there with only single axis in short. Like if you want to understand this with this red color polarization, then for this red color polarization that is along with y axis. So if I say this is x and this is y, so this signal of electric field that is varying with respect to y axis. So electric field that is varying like this, where here it is getting E2, maximum amplitude that is E2, or over here it could be minus E2, and direction of propagation that is there along with z axis, I have considered it is inside the page. So direction of propagation is there inside the page. So this is what linear polarization with respect to y axis. This is linear polarization with respect to y axis. So that is how this linear polarization is there with respect to y axis. So what is linear polarization? Linear polarization is orientation of electric field with respect to one axis. It could be there with respect to x axis, which one can see this is what with respect to x axis, or it could be there with respect to y axis. So it is varying only with respect to y axis. So this is what example of linear polarization. Now let us try to understand what is circular polarization. So in circular polarization, if I say this is x axis and this is y axis, so with respect to time, signal will rotate. Like see, for example, if I say electric field that is there along with x axis at time t is equals to 0. And now if electric field that is oriented in this direction after time t is equals to, let us say, t by 8. So at t by 8, it is over here. Now after 2t by 8, this electric field that reaches over here. So after time 2t by 8, it reaches over here. After time 3t by 8, it reaches here. After time t by 2, it reaches here. After time 5t by 8, it reaches here. After time 60 by 8, or one can say 3t by 4, it reaches here. So see, this is how electric field after time 70 by 8, it is reaching here. So ultimately electric field that is revolving in this direction. So this is what clockwise circular polarization. This is what clockwise circular polarization, where electric field is revolving like this with respect to time. So orientation of electric field that is getting revolved with respect to time. So that is what circular polarization. So in circular polarization, electric field rotates with respect to time. If it rotates in clockwise direction, then that is clockwise circular polarization, and if it rotates in anticlockwise, then it is anticlockwise circular polarization. But when we talk about circular polarization, magnitude of electric field along the axis will not change. Now let us try to understand elliptical polarization. So in elliptical polarization, electric field revolves with respect to time, but magnitude is different on x-axis and y-axis. Here direction of propagation, that is there along with z-axis. So here even direction of propagation, that is there along with z-axis. Let us say this is x-axis, this is y-axis. And now if I say electric field is oriented over here at time t is equals to 0, but magnitude, let us say magnitude of electric field is Ex, then magnitude of electric field is Ex in this direction. Now with respect to time, it is revolving. So it is over here after time t by 8, it is here after time 2t by 8, it will be here after time 3t by 8, over here after time 5t by 8, it will be over here after time 7t by 8, and after time t by 2, it will be over here. After time 3t by 4, it will be over here. So over here even it is revolving. Over here even it will be revolving. But the difference is electric field over x-axis, it is Ex, and over y-axis it is Ey. So magnitude over axis electric field is different. So this is what elliptical polarization. So in elliptical polarization, in elliptical polarization, electric field rotates with respect to time, but the difference is magnitude of electric field, magnitude of electric field is different on x and y axis. So that is how it is different. Now, as if I want to say what could be the basic formula of electric field for circular polarization and for elliptical polarization, then that is quite interesting. So for a calculation of circular polarization, for circular polarization, if I say resultant electric field, that is E, then it will be E dash in x axis, let us say AX direction, plus it will be E dash in y direction, where E dash, that is having same magnitude over x and y direction. So as if you take a basic calculation, then that will be, one can say it will be circles formula. So for circles formula, its magnitude, that will be like Ex square plus Ey square is equals to E dash some magnitude square. So like for example, if I say components are same, so that will result into Ex square plus Ey square is equals to some magnitude square, let us say R square. So that will happen in case of circular polarization. While in case of elliptical polarization, so for elliptical polarization, electric field magnitude will be different for x direction as well as y direction. So if I say it is E1 in x direction and for E2 in y direction, then its basic equation will be ellipse, and that will be Ex square by A square plus Ey square by B square, that is equals to 1. So this is how it is different. So for circular polarization, electric field revolves with respect to time, as well as for elliptical polarization, electric field revolves with respect to time, but magnitude over axis for circular polarization it will be same, and for elliptical polarization magnitude over axis will be different. So this is how polarization is there. Again, let us have a quick review. Polarization is orientation of electric field, and in linear polarization, orientation of electric field, that is happening over an axis. So either it varies on x-axis, either it varies on y-axis, and that one can see over here by diagram. For elliptical polarization, electric field will revolve with respect to time. So if I say it starts from x-axis, with respect to time it revolves and again it will come to the position, but its magnitude over complete circle will remain same, it will not change. While in case of elliptical polarization, it will revolve with respect to time, but magnitude over axis will be different. Like over here, you can see over y axis, electric field is larger than electric field on x axis. So that is why it is what elliptical polarization. So this is what the basic thing which one should understand to understand polarization. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can see my website where I have placed documents regarding courses which I am offering. So you can go through my website. You can see my website in link, website link in description, and from there you can go through my website and you can give me suggestions even. I'll definitely try to provide you solutions of those problems which is there with you if I have understanding based on that. Thank you so much for watching this video.